Welcome to the presentation on feldspar. Feldspar are the most abundant minerals on the earth crust as they account for more than 50% of the crustal composition. This is because they are composed of 6 of the 7 most abundant elements of the earth crust. Feldspar are essential minerals in many igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic rocks and form over a wide range of temperature and pressure. Remember the composition of silica minerals? It was SiO2. In this framework, replace some of the Si4+ with Al3+ and include some of the large monovalent or divalent ions to maintain charge neutrality, the structure we end up with is feldspar. Thus, feldspar are tectosilicate framework for SiO4 and AlO4 tetrahedrons with other cations incorporated in available voids. Like here, potassium ions are located in the voids present in the structure of phanidine, a feldspar. When only one silicon atom is replaced by aluminium in a feldspar formula unit, the formula reverts into XAlSi3O8 and the structure is neutralized by some monovalent cation, usually sodium and potassium. However, when two silicon atoms have been replaced, the formula unit becomes XAl2Si2O8, which is balanced by calcium. Depending on the cation, feldspar may be called orthoclase, anorthite, albite or celsian if it has potassium, calcium, sodium or barium respectively in its void. Most of the other feldspar in the solid solution series can be classified as the ternary system of sodium-rich albite, potassium-rich orthoclase and calcium-rich anorthite, as the feldspar are quite common. Composition between albite and anorthite are called plagioclase feldspar, and those between albite and orthoclase are called alkali feldspars or K feldspars. Notice that the region in the middle of the triangle is not named. This is because at high temperature, feldspar shows the complete solution series, but at lower temperature, these feldspars are not stable as a solution and unmixed to form corresponding plagioclase and alkali feldspar. The region in the triangle where the mineral is not stable for the given temperature and pressure is called the miscibility gap and is shown here in dark. This gap, however, is different for different temperatures and pressures. Feldspar is also a part of Bowen's reaction series. Crystallization of feldspar happens as a continuous series during the cooling of magma. Feldspar are white, grey or red in color. Their hardness is 6 on Mohs scale and their specific gravity ranges from 2.5 to 3.5. Feldspar have two principal cleavages at right angles. Orthoclase feldspar crystallizes in monoclinic system, whereas plagioclase feldspar crystallizes in triclinic system. Feldspar commonly form simple or polysynthetic twins for both. Twin laws followed by feldspar include Carlsbad, Paveno, Mennebach, albite and pericline. Chemical weathering of feldspar minerals involves hydrolysis, in which water molecules rapidly replace various cations in a mineral, thereby transforming it into a clay mineral. When KAlSi3O8 or alkali feldspar reacts with water, it forms kaolinite, which is a clay mineral and releases the potassium cation along with silicic acid. Let us now see some feldspar minerals. Phanidine is an alkaline feldspar and is mostly disordered, which means there is a random distribution of aluminium and silicon ions in the tetrahedral sites. It is found in extrusive, once high temperature lavas that were quickly cooled. Microcline is another alkaline feldspar but is mostly ordered, which means there is a regular distribution of aluminium and silicon in the silicate structure. Its order is a particular characteristic of slowly cooled, deep-seated rocks and pegmatites. Orthoclase shows variable ordering as it is formed at intermediate temperatures in intrusive rocks. Moonstone, a gem variety of orthoclase, is shown here. Thus, whether a specific feldspar will retain its high temperature disordered structure or whether it will transform upon cooling into a more ordered structural state is influenced by the cooling rate of the process. The graph shows possible temperature cooling rate paths phanidine may follow. Quenching is a process of cooling high temperature phanidine so quickly that the resulting mineral preserves all the characteristics of the high temperature state. The varieties of plagioclase feldspar may be described by the relative composition of pure albite and pure anorthite in them. In this way, the solid solution series is divided into 6 minerals, namely albite, aliquoclase, andesite, labradorite, bytonite, and anorthite. Out of these plagioclase feldspars, labradorite shows change of color, due to which the mineral changes its color upon turning the specimen. Coming to occurrences of feldspar, plagioclase feldspar are found in all igneous rocks except ultramafic and ultra-alkaline types. Feldspar are the most important group of rock-forming minerals and they are the dominant component of most igneous rocks. With regards to their occurrences in igneous rocks, feldspar containing sodium characterize the more acidic rocks, whereas calcic feldspar characterize the more basic rocks. Also, the general structure of plagioclase feldspar is very similar to that of microclase. Feldspars are mined from large granite bodies called pluta by geologists found in pegmatites. These pegmatites are formed during the last fluid stages when a crystallizing granite becomes concentrated in pockets, and this allows the growth of extremely large crystals. Feldspars are also extracted from sands composed of feldspar. Feldspars are also common mineral in the lunar surface rocks. Most feldspars there are calcic plagioclase, that is AN90 to AN95 anorthite, with the minerals rocks being called anorthosite. In fact, up to 70 to 99% of the lunar highlands are composed of this plagioclase feldspar, which in the image appears to be white. There are also several uses of feldspar minerals. Feldspar is sometimes used to make dinnerware, and it is also used to make bathroom and building tiles. In ceramics and glass production, feldspar is used as a flux. This flux is a material that lowers the melting temperature of another material, in this case, glass. Finally, let us look at the various differences between quartz and feldspar. Quartz is composed only of silicon oxide, whereas feldspar also have alkali elements. Quartz crystallizes in hexagonal system, but feldspar crystallizes in monoclinic and triclinic system. Hardness and specific gravity of feldspar is less than quartz, and quartz have no cleavage, whereas feldspar had two sets of cleavage. Feldspar crystallizes before quartz, and finally, quartz is much more resistant to weathering than feldspar. That's all. Thank you for watching.